8th standard, chapter 2, linear equations in one variable. The last video we started exercise 2.2. We will do some more questions from this. We have done first question. Now we can take like third one, in which given that the base of an isosceles triangle, the base of isosceles triangle is given as 4 by 3 cm, and also given the perimeter, the perimeter of the triangle, the perimeter of the triangle given that is equal to 4 integer 2 by 15. So we can convert it in the improper fraction. 15 folds are 60 plus 2, 62 upon, then it is easier for us. So 15 folds are 60 plus 2, 62 upon 15 centimeter. Now we have to find the length of either of the remaining equal sides. Because it is isosceles triangle, you mean two sides are equal. And that we have to find. So we can start like that. Let the length of two equal sides is equal to x centimeter. Now, according to the condition, what is given that perimeter of triangle is given 62 upon 15 centimeters. Therefore, we know that perimeter means sum of the three sides. Therefore, sum of three sides is equal to 62 upon 15. Now two sides are x and x, because both the two equal sides are x and x, means x plus third side is given base 4 by 3. You get 62 upon 15. Now x plus x is 2x. Therefore, you can write down 2x plus 4 upon 3 is equal to 62 upon 15. Now, therefore 2x. Now we will transpose this 4 by 3, that side. So it will be minus. So it is equal to 62 upon 15 minus 4 upon 3. Here first we will take the LCM. So 2x is equal to, now 15 and 3, LCM will be 15 only. So 15 will be here, so 62 as it is, minus here 3. So we have to multiply it with 5 to get 15. So 5 fours are 20. So you get a 2x is equal to, now 62 minus 20 is how much? 42. Now just 2, you have to take other side. So it is in the multiplication. So it will go in the denominator. So x is equal to 42 upon 15 multiplied by 2. 2 20 ones are 42. So we get x is equal to 21 upon 15. Now remember, if the answer is in the improper fraction, we have to convert generally in the mixed fraction. So you can do in the rough 21 divided by 15. 15 ones are 15. 6. So what is the answer? 1 integer 6 upon 15. Therefore x is equal to 1 integer 6 upon 15 centimeter. Now you have to write down the separate answer, that answer is, mean the length of the two equal sides is 6 by 15, one integer 6 upon 15 centimeter each. Okay. Now here you can see that either doing this, it will be simplified also. Here you can do that 7 3s are 21, 5 3s are 15, 3 cancel and you get 7 upon 5. So you can do that also, not a problem. So here 7 upon 5 you can convert into mixed fraction and you can write down. Actually not even necessary to convert into the mixed fraction, but if it is in the like MCQ and answer is in that, it is necessary. But here you can write down, therefore you can write down the final answer, that length of the both equal sides is 7 upon 5 centimeter each. Now we can move to another question. And other questions also you have to do it yourself. Any difficulties, write down in the section, comment section. So now we can take another question, like take one with the ratio. Two numbers are in the ratio. What is the ratio given is 5:3. And also given that if they differ by 18, yes, what are the numbers? Differ means when we subtract them, bigger minus smaller, the answer is 18. And we have to find that both numbers. So now whenever the numbers have the ratio, how can we find that two numbers? So here we can start the solution. First we write down the ratio of two numbers is 5:3. It means that the numbers, we can relate the numbers are, so 5:3. So we don't know the perfect number, so we have to take x with it. Means numbers are 5x and 3x. Because it can be multiple of 5 and it can be multiple of 3. So we have to take 5x and 3x. Now, according to the condition, what is given? They differ by 18. So you can write down the numbers differ by 18. It means that if you subtract them, 5x minus 3x is equal to 18. Now, very simple sum. 5x minus 3x is how much? 2x. So 2x is equal to 18. So we get x is equal to 18 upon 2. So x is equal to 9. That is not the answer. That is the value of x only. We have to find the both the numbers. Therefore, the first number, what we took as 5x, to put the value of x, 5 multiplied by 9. So 5 9s are 45. And the second number or the other number we have taken as 3x. So 3 multiplied by 9, 9 3s are 27. Now you can confirm also your answer. Subtract 45 minus 27, you will get the answer 18. It means your answer is perfect. So you can have this. So whenever there is a ratio, we have to do like that. With them, we have to take x or y or z, but generally we are comfortable with x. So don't go for the other variable. Let's do some more questions. Okay. Now we will take number 11. The Baichung. Baichung's father is 26 years. Baichung's father is 26 years younger than his grandfather, and 29 years older than Baichung. Maybe in some books, the new books, in place of Baichung, I think there is other name also. But I have the book in which there is a Baichung name. So don't get confused, because in the new books, I think Bharat or something is written. So the name is not important, just we have to do the sum. So here given that 29 years older than Baichung. Also given that the total age of all three, the sum of ages of all three becomes how much? 135 years. And we have to find the ages of all the three people. Means age of Baichung, age of his father, and age of his grandfather. So now how to do it? So first of all, youngest is the Baichung. So we will take Baichung's present age as X years. So write down, let the present age of Baichung is equal to X years. Now look at the second. His father is 29 years older than Baichung. So what will be the father's age? We have to add 29 in Baichung's age. Therefore, Baichung's father's age is equal to X plus 29 years. Now here there is some thing to remember. You have to think about it. Given that Baichung's father is 26 years younger than his grandfather, it means that if you go reverse, his grandfather is 26 years older than his father. So we can write down Baichung's grandfather's age is equal to his father's age plus 26 years. What is his father's age? X plus 29 plus 26 means X plus 55 years. So Baichung's age we take as X years, father's age X plus 29 years, and grandfather's age is X plus 55 years. Now according to the condition, what is given? That sum of the ages is 135 years. So now we can write down, according to condition, sum of their ages is equal to 135 years. It means that X plus 29 plus X plus 55 is equal to 135. Now you have to just simplify. X plus X plus X, it is 3X. So 3X plus 29 plus 55 will do 84 is equal to 135. So now we will transpose. So 3x is equal to 135 minus 84. So now we have to subtract 135 minus 84. Here 15, 2. 15 minus 4. No, we don't have to do, sorry. 5 minus 4 is 1. Here we have to take. So here it will be 0. 13 minus 8, 5. So 51. So 3x is equal to 51. So x is equal to 51 divided by 3. We know that 51 divided by 3 is 17. So now we have to find all the ages. Therefore, Baichung's age is equal to x is equal to 17 years. His father's age, what did you take father's age? X plus 29. Means we have to add 17 plus 29. 9 plus 7, 16, carry 1, 4. 46 years. So his father's age is 46 years. And grandfather's age. It is x plus 55, means 17 plus 55. 72 years. So we got all three ages. Baichung age 17, father's 46 years, and grandfather's 72. Now we can add them, you will get 135. So here that first sentence is little confusing. That his father's age 26 years younger than grandfather. So we have to take reverse, that grandfather is 26 years older than his father. So we get here 3 x years for Baichung, 29 x plus 29 for father, and x plus 29 plus 26 means x plus 55. Then after that, very simple, sum of them is 135. You simplify and you get the answers. So now in all the questions it will be same thing like that. You have to take x for something, read the relationships, and after relationship you have to make a question according to the, means you have to create a equation in one variable. Then after that, to solve the equation is very, very simple. So I think you will be able to do the other sums. So rather we will carry forward. Now, until now we say that there was variable only one side, means either it was only on the LHS or only in the RHS. Now the second type is the solving equations having the variable on both sides, means the unknown number variable x will be on the both sides, will be on the LHS also and it will be on the RHS also. And then how do we find the solution? Let's take an examples, because it is, if I explain directly you won't understand properly. So rather we will take an example. Look here, solve 2x minus 3 equals x plus 2. This is given. So we will start here. Solution 2x minus 3 is equal to x plus 2. Now in this situation what we have to do? Generally what we do that we have to keep the terms with variables on one side and the others like constants, we have to take on the other side. And but be careful while transposing. You have to remember that plus to minus, minus to plus, multiply to divide, divide to multiply. So first of all, we will bring x this side. So 2x, here there is no sign, it means there is a plus sign, which comes here on the LHS will become minus x. Similarly, minus 3 will go that side because it is constant. So minus 3 will become plus 3. So 2 is there, minus 3 will become plus 3. So now we separate them. Variable only one side, constant on the other side. Now we have to simplify. 2x minus x means 1 upon x, I mean 1x. 2x minus x is 1x and 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Very simple. So here, not wasting time on the examples, we can start the exercise 2.3. Question number 1. Solve the following equations and check your results. Well, you have to check the results also. 3x is equal to 2x plus 18. Now let me tell you that check the results, that you have to do it in your mind or on the rough page. You don't have to mention it, because in the exams we will only do the questions like that. So now 2x we have to bring this side, so it will be minus 2x. 3x minus 2x is equal to 18. So now 3x minus 2x means 1x. We don't write down 1. So x is equal to 18. That is your final answer. And how to check the answer? As they said, check your results. So put 18 on LHS. LHS is 3x. What is the answer? 18 threes are 54. So LHS answer will be 54. That you can do in the rough page. 2x plus 18 on the RHS. We will put value of x as 18. 18 to the 36. 36 plus 18, 54. Both sides answer equal. It means that your answer is right. So verification can be done like this way. Take another example like third one. Or take fourth one. 4z plus 3. Here sometimes z and 2 is looking same. So rather when you write down z, do like that. So 4z plus 3 is equal to 6 plus 2z. Because sometimes people write down 2 also same, z also same, then it can be 2z. In place of 2z it will be 22, and that will be misleading. And you can get the wrong answer. So rather, whenever the z come in this algebra especially, then you have to do like that for your convenience, not compulsory. So now here 2z we will bring this side. So 4z plus 2z becomes minus 2z. 6 plus 3 going that side becomes minus 2. Therefore 4z minus 2z is 2z. 6 minus 3 is 3. So 4z minus 2z is equal to 6 minus 3. So 4z minus 2z is 2z. So z is equal to 3 upon 2. So we can write down in the mixed fraction also 1 integer 1 upon 2. And that is your answer. Take another one. Little difficult one. You can take the 8th one. 2x upon 3 plus 1 is equal to 7x upon 15 plus 3. It looks difficult, but not really. So here you can see that two terms are having x. One is on the LHS, one is on the RHS. So we will bring that term from RHS to LHS by transposing. It means that 2x upon 3 minus 7x upon 15. When we are bringing whole term, we don't have to go to numerator to denominator. Only one number is bringing, that time we have to do that. Is equal to 3 plus 1 becomes minus 1. Now here when there is a denominator, we know that what we have to do? We have to find the LCM. So LCM is 15. So therefore, what we will do here? 2x upon 3 multiplied by 5 upon 5 minus 7x upon 15 into 1 upon 1, because it is 15 already, is equal to 3 minus 1 is 2. So now here 5 to the 10x upon 3 5 is 15 minus 7x upon 15 is equal to 2. So here 15 is LCM, so 10x minus 7x. 10x minus 7x is 3x. So 3x upon 15 is equal to 2. So we can get the final answer here. So we get 3x is equal to 2 multiplied by 15. 3 also we will bring that side. So x is equal to 2 multiplied by 15 divided by 3. Now we can do the cancellation. 3, 5, and the answer is x is equal to 2. So very, very, very simple. Only you have to remember that the terms having variable must bring on one side. So here we transpose 7x upon 15 to this side becomes minus, then we have to take LCM, make them equal fractions, and then simplify. Then you get the value of the x. So here the other sums you can do it yourself. Okay, let me take one more example. The last one. 3m is equal to 5m minus 8 upon 5. Here also we can do the same thing here. 3m minus 5m. Sometimes here people are making a mistake. What? That they take 5m, here remaining 8 upon 5. But they will forget that 8 upon 5 has negative sign. So there we have to keep it. Why? Because we are not changing its sides. It is only on the RHS. Therefore, it must retain, it must keep its sign. So now, 3m minus 5m. What is it? Minus 2m. Now, if there is minus sign on both the sides, you can take it off. So we can write down now 2m is equal to 8 upon 5. Now take 2, that side will go in the denominator. So m is equal to 8 upon 5 into 2. 2 1s are 2 4s are. So we get m is equal to 4 upon 5. So by this way, if there is any sub, you can do the other remaining sums also. So today we are going to end our session today. Any problem in the remaining sums or any steps, write down in the comment section. Thank you very much.